It's been so hot lately that we had to move the mattress into the living room because the AC is in the living room and the room is fucking hot. Workout. Already had a coffee. Don't really need the caffeine. Just want the pump. Cheers. Time to work out. Gym fit of the day. HH sweats. AF1s. ASRV. HH hat. Neon. And then I got a tank. Alright, let's go. Alright, so the first part of my routine is the morning routine. I like to keep it simple. I've tried many different things, but what I've found to work best for me is wake up, obviously do the main things, brush my teeth, wash my face, make my bed.
Always make your bed.
And then I'll make coffee, have some water, and then I'll sit down and start reading. And I try to read 10 pages in the morning. Before, I was waking up at 5 a.m., I was doing the whole 20-minute mobility, then I was doing 20 minutes of reading, 20 minutes of meditation, and it just took up so much time, I felt. So I feel like I found a good routine where it's not taking up way too much time. I'll just check my notebook, see what I have to do for the day, because the night before, when I kind of write down my whole plan for the day, I try to get to bed at 10. And then wake up around 6 nowadays. I actually don't go to the gym right away. I've been doing it so that wake up, I do my morning routine, and I get right to work, and then I go to the gym around 2. But today, it's one of those days. I have a lot of stuff going on this afternoon, so quick workout right now. It's 8 o'clock. Let's smash it. It's go time. Jay on the beat. Quick workout, 1 hour workout. Usually if I do my workout in the morning, then I'll just get to work right after. And I pretty much work like all day. Sometimes I'll work literally until the night. Obviously I have little breaks and stuff. You'll see, every day is different. That's honestly something that I'm super grateful for with, you know, running my own business. Like something I gotta remind myself, because there's a lot of challenges, you know, hard ass days and challenges, but I gotta remind myself that, you know, at the end of the day, I am my own boss, and that's why I even decided to begin this entrepreneurial journey in the first place. There's a routine to kind of keep things in flow, but you know, there's always different challenges, different things to work on, so it's the fun in it.
I just wanted to call to clarify, I was just wondering, is that for the t-shirts or is that for the muscle tanks?
Alright, I'm in a bit of a rush right now, but I'm gonna put together an outfit. I gotta go, I'm meeting up with the boy Farshad. We're gonna talk about business and all that kind of stuff. HH shorts, black tank top. I got it from Walmart, George brand. We gotta make this quick. HH socks, these are the new ones. Asics Gel Cayano 14s. Here's the outfit. This is my like go-to outfit on a really hot day. I'll either do these like big shorts, like I like big baggy shorts, or short shorts. It's either or, you know, nothing in between. As you guys may or may not know, I work with ASRV. So these, I really love these shorts. This is the stone in black. These kind of look like cream color. I got this, which is an all white cutoff tank. Yeah, nice ass material. We got fans everywhere because it is hot. How's it look?
Really nice.
Woo! I'll try on the shorts just cause. The black liner is just so clean. And again, it's crazy because I would have never thought that I'd be getting free clothing just for making videos. Start posting TikToks, you can get hit up by brands and work with them. Try on this one. I just wanted the black, I don't wear black with anything. This is like really nice mesh material for the gym. Black tee with the black liner and then like a different color. Always looks really good in my opinion. This is their new duffel bag. It's the travel duffel bag. I'm going to New York on the 9th. Like I'm gonna do a full New York vlog, but I'm gonna be bringing this to New York and I'm gonna shoot some videos for ASRV. Big bag, a lot of pockets. There's like a shoe pouch right here. This thing's detachable. You can kind of make it like a side bag, which is crazy. Really dope cop. This buckle is nuts. Attach it right here. And I believe you can also take this, take these, and then it's kind of like a messenger bag in a way. Nice size bag if you just want to do like a day trip or whatever. Pretty dope. I think the Zane trying to tell you something. I came in with a cool heart. Yeah, have a good day. Had to drop off the whip, switch up the tire. There's a hole in the tire, ran over a nail. Now back home, I'm gonna get to work once again. When it comes to routines, I've really realized over the past little while that I am like my happiest when I'm on my routine. And don't get me wrong, like I love traveling, I love partying, I love being with the homies, I love just like going out and doing shit and, you know, being spontaneous. But I don't know, I've just come to a point where I know myself and I feel that I'm my happiest when I'm on my routine, doing what I need to do to grow my business, my career, and everything that's important to me. It gives me the time to read, meditate, work, build my business, build the things in my life that I want to build. You know, financial freedom is a big goal of mine. Stuff like that, you know? Okay, so a few things I do for productivity. Number one, sleep. If I'm not sleeping well, I just feel like shit all day. I'm not productive. And like, as much as people say, like, get up at 5 a.m., grind, I personally love the idea of getting up at 5 a.m. and working all day. Whenever I do wake up at 5 a.m., feel great. But then 12 p.m. arrives, 1 p.m., it's crash. Oh. Usually, that's just because my body's not used to it. I didn't sleep well the night before or whatever. But anyways, long story short, it doesn't matter what time you get up. You just need to get enough sleep for your body. And I personally feel like I need 7 to 8 hours. Like 8 hours is optimal. So if I wanna wake up at 5, I gotta go to bed at like 9. But that usually ends up being like 10:30, 11. And then I end up not getting a shitty sleep and then not being productive the next day. So I think getting up early is great. And you can be very productive, but you have to go to bed early. So, and mental health for me, like when I am going through periods of like where I just don't feel like myself or I don't feel good, I'm not productive. And I think it is what it is, you know, we all have those days. It's just important, just, you know, it's important to take care of your mental health. And if your mental health is taken care of, you know, your health routine is on point, you feel good, you're fueling your body with good nutrients and good information and water and all that, and you know, you're going to bed on time, like you're going to feel good, and that just directly impacts, you know, your productivity and your output. Number two, power list. Five things, priorities: film vlog, call RT, one of my suppliers, 2 hours core study, ship hat, post on TikTok. So this has probably been the most beneficial for me in terms of productivity is my power list. Last night I look at kind of like what I need to do for the week, and I write down five things, five of my main priorities for the day. Keep it simple, five things. I don't make them too complicated. I don't make these tasks too long. And sometimes I don't get all five done, but the days that I do, I feel amazing. Maybe you've done this before, you know, you fill your list of like 15 to-dos, and you do like maybe 5 to 10, you have 5 left over and you're like, fuck, it wasn't a successful day, right? So keep it simple, and over time, you'll be able to feel better every day. And if I feel like doing more, I do more. If I feel like chilling, I can chill and I don't feel guilty. Number three, limit distractions. This is why I try not to go on my phone first thing in the morning, because it's just a distraction. Like I'll go on and I'll start scrolling and I'll start looking at what other people are doing. But I need to focus on what I'm doing. I gotta be selfish first thing in the morning and take care of myself so that I can do the rest, take care of others and whatnot. So I set time blocks on my apps. I believe it's like an hour each app. Lastly, do the important things first, which is kind of like the power list. I just write down my priorities and just get those things done. Because if you wake up in the morning, you limit those distractions, you get right to work on the most important things, you'll feel so good. And that's what's worked for me, so. Yes, sir, it is so hot. I'm pretty much sweating right now. All right, let's move on. Yeah. Evening routine is something I've been slacking on the most and the thing that I need to work on the most, because I know if I have a good evening routine, then my morning goes really well. And it doesn't have to be anything too complicated. It literally is just go to bed early so you can get up early. Building a routine to remind me to go to bed on time and to get off my phone as well, because the phone can really mess with your sleep. Blue light, like if the goal is going to bed at 10, which it is right now, go to bed at 10, wake up at 6. Yeah, I just try to put my phone aside 9 p.m. and then from 9 to 10, it's just activities that I do to try to just not be on my phone. So cleaning up the kitchen, getting my coffee station ready for the morning, cleaning up my office and the living room, and then obviously brushing my teeth, washing my face, and maybe I'll do a little bit of reading in bed or just on the couch, just to kind of like mellow down for the night. And that's really it. It's simple. This is what a lot of people say, is that like your morning starts in the evening, in the sense that if you go to bed early and if you go to bed on time, you're gonna have such a better morning. And I know that's the case for myself. If I get a good sleep, my morning is just on point. My next day is on point. I'm productive. Anyways, I hope this video helped you guys out. I hope you enjoyed it. We're gonna be going ham on the YouTube channel within the next little while, so I'm excited for what's to come. Thank you guys for following along the journey. If you guys are trying to instill a routine into your life, just keep working at it. I've been working at this for 3-4 years now, just trying to figure out what works for me, and it's always changing. Just keep working at it. You got this shit. And happy September. Let's get it, guys. Let's get it.